Hello. Today we're going to be talking a little bit about what it looks like for a JavaScript developer to start programming with AI. If you're a new JavaScript developer, if you've done it a little bit, you might just be curious how to get started and what kind of tool set there is. Historically, as a front-end developer myself, most of the time you're just working in the browser. You're used to working in the console, kind of pulling things around in there. There's definitely a much better tool set available to you as you kind of start this journey. So I want to talk a little bit about kind of what that looks like for a front-end developer. So say you're a front-end developer and you're looking for a place to get started. You could look at OpenAI. They've got a lot of great examples. And if we kind of open the dropdown here, you can see that they do have Node.js examples, right? And, you know, you can open up a terminal. You can kind of run these anywhere that you can run Node. And you can kind of go ahead and get started really quite easily with this. But for people working with data, people working with AI, there are already a lot of existing tools for this. One of the most famous is a Jupyter Notebook. Jupyter Notebook is a really kind of fantastic place to explore and experiment, but it is a very Python-based tool. So I've got my Jupyter Notebook here that I use when I do some development work. And in here, you can kind of see what the code is running. You can run kind of pieces of your code bit by bit, getting the output as you go. So it's really convenient. But again, this is, of course, Python. This is not JavaScript. And when we start thinking about how to use these sorts of tools for JavaScript developers, we really see that there's a pretty strong divide where you've got front end, full stack, back-end developers most familiar with JavaScript, and then you've got kind of data scientists, machine learning engineers, data experts. They're often most familiar with like Python and Python-like languages or SQL. So there's a pretty like distant connection between these two, right? They're kind of very different languages. They solve problems in a very different way. And so if you're kind of interested in working in this space, which is AI, you have to kind of think about what tools are available to you to help kind of bridge this gap. And that's really where we started looking at a front-end tool set that uses like Dino. Dino, for those of you who don't know, is an alternative library to Node. Node is, of course, a very kind of like tried and true library, but Dino sort of offers a more performant, more optimized version of Node. And it's very backwards compatible with a lot of different modules. And in one of the most recent versions, they actually introduced a sort of modern JavaScript runtime for Jupyter Notebooks. And so you can kind of run your Dino upgrade, go ahead and install that. You'll, of course, need to install Dino first as well before getting started with this. But then the main command that you need to run is this kind of Dino Jupyter unstable. And that'll actually get running on your system here. And then once that's started, you could, of course, have a whole Jupyter Notebook instance running, have that running on your computer. I think you will actually have to have Python installed and run this Jupyter lab here, but we don't actually have to run Jupyter. The really cool thing about Dino is that, and now that it's in Jupyter lab, is we can actually use the Jupyter Notebooks inside of VS Code. And I find VS Code a much better interface for me to do work in. So now we're inside of Visual Studio Code. And the first thing you're going to want to do is add the Jupyter Notebook. So I'm going to search for Jupyter. And you'll see it here. This is the kind of Jupyter Notebook bundle of extensions. And this will add Jupyter to your system. Then, after that's been installed and added, what you can do when you open up the drawer, you can do Jupyter. And you can see that there's like create a new Jupyter Notebook. So I'll click that. That'll open up this sort of Jupyter Notebook space here. And then you'll have to select a kernel. And when you get this dropdown initially, you'll have Python environments, Jupyter kernels, or a Jupyter server running somewhere. We're going to select Jupyter kernel, and then Dino should show up on your system. And so now that we're running this, we can go ahead and start coding. And so I'm going to output some value. I can do my console.logs whatever I want. And now you can see that'll run, output this value, right? And now we don't actually have to keep re-executing the same code, right? So if I wanted to use X somewhere else, right? I can use that same variable that's been defined earlier and run a separate code block down here. Now, this is really beneficial because I may not want to kind of rerun code, especially when I'm working with like an API that you have to pay for. I may want to be able to run the API, get back some code, and then maybe I'm working on like parsing JSON or processing the JSON that was output. I'll want to just take that JSON that I got and use it. And I don't want to necessarily have to make that API call every single time while I'm just experimenting. If you imagine that you're building an app, you may actually be testing the app every time to get to where you needed to go. You either have to do that or you have to set up that data that came out of the API, send it into a file, then load the file. It gets really tricky. But you can imagine that now I've got this sort of notebook space where I can keep these variables cached. And I can just kind of access that same variable multiple times as I kind of write new code or make changes. The other thing you can do is you can add lines of markdown. So here I could add something where I'm now going to do my processing, right? And now I've got this documentation along with this code, which is actually really great for also teaching your team or helping people understand something that's a little bit more complicated. Or giving yourself notes to remind yourself what you learned at some point. This is just a really great space for you to be able to learn things. So we're going to go actually open up another one of these notebooks that I've got, this demo notebook here. And in here, you can kind of see that kind of an example of using LangChain. This is a library that you can use for coding in AI. There's also Llama Index, which is another library similar to this. Kind of aggregates a bunch of different tools like OpenAI, different AI APIs, and really helps you kind of put that all in one place. So what you can do is I've kind of created some markdown up at the top. So this is going to be this notebook. I'm going to add my dependencies. So you can see here I'm adding, this is a NPM package. This is the full path to that NPM package that I want to pull from. Basically, in order to pull these things in Dino, in this Jupyter notebook environment, you just have to preface everything with NPM colon, and that'll help you import these different values. I'm going to set my OpenAI API key. I'm going to set up my models using now this imported OpenAI object. So you can see here, I can create an LLM object, or I can create a chat model specifically, and it'll set everything up for chat. And then we can actually call our models down here. And so you can see here, this is what a LLM call looks like. So I'm calling this LLM API that we set up here. And I'm calling predict, what is the meaning of life? And then the really cool thing is Dino also offers some really cool display capability as well. So I can do some HTML outputting. So what I've done is I've put this LLM result into a paragraph text, but you could also do like maybe some bold text. Oh, and just before like we kind of show the bold text, I'll just run it again. So you can see here I've made this call. I've gotten this LLM result back from the predict call endpoint here. And then you can see we're outputting that to HTML and we're bolding it, right? And if I wanted to change this or iterate on it, put it in italics, something like that, I could do the same thing and you can kind of get some output here. So that's just kind of a brief kind of overview of really what's possible for this sort of front-end toolkit with Dino and any AI tool that you want. It really helps kind of bridge this gap between front-end developers and data scientists. And I think it'll be a really great tool for you to be able to learn more about AI, especially as a JavaScript developer. Thanks so much for watching. I'd love it if you subscribe and consider following us on blog.stablediscussion.com. We have a lot of different AI posts and content on there. And we're also publishing a podcast from time to time. So keep an eye out for us. Awesome. Thanks so much.